Welcome to our first episode of the Lobo Live, Tales of the Lobo, the podcast where we'll be deep diving into the lives, experiences, and stories of our fellow classmates. I am your host, Leslie Alcaraz, and today we have some exciting guests with us. Please welcome our Lopez Ambassadors, President Jolette Mercado, and our Lopez Ambassador, historian Aileen Flores. How are you guys doing today?
Hello, everyone. I'm doing good today.
Hi, guys. This is Aileen. I'm a bit cold. It's rainy outside.
Yeah, it is. The weather's kind of crazy right now in Texas.
It's sweater weather today, guys.
That's true.
Sweater weather. It's very exciting. Okay, so, you know, today we're going to be asking you some... Oh, and we have a special guest as well entering right now, Karime. She's in the house, guys. So say hi, Karime, to everyone.
Hi, everyone. I'm so happy to be part of this interview today, and I feel very honored. Thank you for having me.
She is our secretary for ambassadors as well, guys. So that is very exciting. So today I'm just going to be asking you guys some questions. You know, we want to get to know you guys a bit better, what you do here at school. So to kick things off, you know you guys are involved in a lot of things, but what have you been up to lately? You know, what have you been trying to get done? You know, some of your goals that you've been trying to do as of right now.
Well, I mean, I think I may start so far. And I mean, I know how it feels like to have a crazy life and the way that you're involved in a lot of extracurricular activities. I'm an officer for plenty of programs. And so far, our main hassle, especially as an ambassador, was working for homecoming, making sure it was splendid for everyone who went. And if you guys did go, I hope you guys had a great time. But also, today actually is for NHS ceremony. So right now, we're all over the place. All people that are here are part of the National Society. And we are hoping that goes very well, actually.
Yes. What about you, Aileen? What have you been up to lately?
Well, so far, guys, we have a special surprise for y'all in the month of October. Just be ready to cash out some money and pay for tickets. It's going to be really fun.
Yes. It'll be worth your while.
What about you, Karime? What have you been up to?
Well, like Jolette said, right now, my main focus has been the NHS ceremony. Which is today, so I'm really hoping that goes very smoothly. I think we will. The program is filled with a lot of really good and intelligent students, so I know that it'll go very well.
Yeah, that's good. I know you guys are involved in a lot of things, you know, like you have said. Especially, you know, the two main ones are ambassadors and NHS. So what do you guys see from those clubs, you know, like how do you view them? Do you see, oh, is it like a burden to you, or is it like something that you really enjoy to do?
Well, for me personally, I feel like any person can have the burdens that they have. Mm-hmm. But for me, when I am a part of extracurricular activities, I feel like that is my escape. I feel like that's where I'm able to do whatever I want, be able to succeed, help others out. That's something about me. I feel like I can be very caring. Mm-hmm. And I know that I could be very determined. And when I want us to do something, I will make sure we do it. But it's not just because, oh, I want to do it. But I want to make sure that our student body has fun. Our student body can actually experience like one of those like little, like I think, high school musical moments or something, yeah. Whatever. I want us to actually enjoy our year, especially I'm a senior. So I want my senior class to be able to be like, you know what? Our senior year was the best year, especially since we're COVID kids. Yeah. So freshman year took us away a lot. And then still sophomore year, it was like till like half semester where we finally felt like things were getting back in place. Mm-hmm. And then junior year, we were slowly getting the ropes of everything. So now senior year, I feel like we should be prepared. And I just really wanted it to be like a splendid year.
Yeah, that's great. That's awesome. What about you, Aileen? What, you know, what do you think about these programs? What have you been doing lately in these programs?
Well, we're all kind of involved in like different programs, right? But I think that it's because of like the programs that we choose is a part of like who we want to be or who we aspire to be. Because most of the programs, they have like different values and stuff like that. Like, let's take NHS, for example. It's all about like commitment and dedication to like helping serve your community. And I think that we're all a part of that because we want to help like make our community a better place to live in. And then like another example is I'm in HOSA, which stands for Future Health Professionals, right? And that's because of like my dedication and passion towards medicine. And I think that's like making me like a more like well-rounded person.
Yeah, I feel like to add on to that, another program that it's very insightful for plenty of students and which it should bring more recognition towards it are our career pathways. I know Karime is in education. Mm-hmm. Eileen is for medical, and I'm over here for law enforcement. And we are students who represent, Karime represented us at nationals. I represented you guys at state for both my divisions. Eileen's representing our school with Jose when she went over there to Corpus. And I feel like it is something that's very significant to be able to have, because you know what? Our life, we take charge of that right now. And it sounds scary to say, because at times I'm like, why am I doing this? Like, I'm not even sure if I want to be, let's say, a lawyer when I'm older, a doctor, or a teacher. But you start now. And I'm thankful for those programs, because it really has let me see reality faster, if that makes sense.
What about you, Karime? What is your input in all of this?
I do agree with that. Well, with the fact that being career in a career pathway class right now is really helpful for the future, because I feel like even if you don't end up liking what you're doing, that's time that you don't, that's time, that's valuable time that's not going to be taken up in the future. Let's say in college, where you're going to be taking these classes, or you're going to join a workforce, and then into the workforce, you're going to be like, you know what? I don't really like this, because now we can figure this out in high school where it's not going to cost us money, not going to cost us valuable time. And as for Taffy, I had the pleasure of, last year was actually my first year competing, where I wrote a children's book in Spanish. And I did it with a girl in my class. Her name's Maria Cortez. We wrote this book together, and it took us all the way to nationals. And we actually placed sixth. So I was very, that was very, a very proud moment for me, because it was like, wow, like, my, because I was the illustrator for this book, so I was like, wow, my drawings like got recognized at a national level. And I just think that's one of my biggest academic accomplishments as of right now.
That's a great story to have, honestly. That's like, cool. It's so beautiful. I love it. I love it.
You're a whole artist taking your artwork everywhere.
It's like Hispanics were sometimes underappreciated, and it's like, yeah, you guys literally put us there in the spot, especially coming from like a low community, a poverty school, Lopez High School. And that's at Lopez. Not all the time has the greatest reputation within all the schools, but you guys, but like, for instance, the people that are here on this table have been able to make that difference and have been able to, you know what, Lopez isn't like a bad school. Like, look at the students they have.
And it was such a like reality check, because I met people from Alaska. I met people Ohio, and I was, and they would be like, oh, where are you from? And I'd be like, oh, I'm from Brownsville, Texas. And then they're like, what's that? Like, they've never even heard of
it. Yeah, it's crazy.
And it's just like, it was such an amazing experience. It was actually my first time leaving the state. And it was amazing that I got to do that and make an impact, not only for like the school, but also I feel like it kind of put Brownsville on the map. Like, now people are going to be like, oh, I remember that girl. Or I remember she mentioned this town called Brownsville.
Yeah.
So hopefully they'll remember that. Like, I remember them.
So I know we're talking about all about academics here, but you know, we have a life outside of school, you know, although our life does revolve a lot around school, you know, we spend a lot of time here. But how do you guys manage your time, you know, to be able to balance like your real life, you know, and your academics?
This is a quick little shout out to Ms. Davila, the cheer coach. Thanks to that lady. And I mean, even before that, I've always liked planners. I feel like for me, what helps me make sure that I'm on track with my life, making sure that I'm not forgetting about anything, whether it's assignments, exams, tests, study sessions, or having to come to an ambassador meeting or any meeting in general, are my planners. That way I write it down, I have it color-coded. And I think that pretty much sums up my life, that or my phone. My phone, the calendars, and I'll set a quick reminder. And that helps me out for, let's say I'm not looking at my planner at all, but like a random moment at night, the day before, I'll get like a reminder like, oh, you have a meeting tomorrow. And I feel like for me, that's what helps me stay in track, and I recommend it. Like, let's say you're AVID teachers, if you have are part of the AVID program, and you might think that, oh, like the planners aren't gonna help you out, the planners are just gonna be like, it's a waste of time. Believe it or not, it's super important, and it's something that's gonna be, I feel like, a requirement for when you go to college, when you start your workforce or your career. It's gonna be extremely beneficial, just know that.
What are your techniques, Eileen, to manage your time?
For me, so this is kind of funny. Okay, guys. So for me, I just like casually mention it to my mom, right? And then she's the one that remembers for me. And she's always like, oh, Eileen, you have to do this. And oh, Eileen, you have to do that. And I'm like really thankful for
her, like,
right?
Okay.
Because like she remembers for me. And like, that's a bit weird, right? But like, at least she remembers. So she helps me remember.
That's great.
You know, moms are a good reminder. Yes, just throw everything onto them and they bring it back onto you. Yes. What about you, Karime? How do you manage your time?
I have the same AVID teacher as Jolet, and she's not lying, like, when she said that they're so helpful having a planner. Like, I remember my sophomore year when she would first ask us to do a planner, I'd be like, oh, like, there's no point of this. I don't really need it. And now my senior year, that planner is what keeps me in check. My days are like a rainbow because every different event is a different color and I highlight so it stands out. And I'll look at my planner, I'll be like, I have a meeting today at 6. I have to do this tomorrow at this. Especially now, senior year, with all these activities going on, a planner is honestly like the best thing you can invest in. Yeah. They're actually so helpful, especially when you actually keep up with them.
Yeah, it is. I mean, unless like you don't barely look at it, and then that explains why you forget a lot of things or you don't even have anything on it, because then you're gonna say, well, the excuse, like, oh, you know what, like, I didn't know about it. But also I feel like a planner is a way I could defend myself sometimes, because I feel like there'll be times where teachers are like, oh, well, I gave this to you guys yesterday and I'm expecting it to be done, and I could be like, oh no, like, you gave it to us this day and you said that you were gonna let us have it done by this day. You get me? Because I know sometimes teachers tend to forget, and I mean, the planner's a reminder to me and it could be a reminder also to them.
Yes. Okay, so next question, guys. So what do you, we already talked about all about academics, right, and everything you guys are involved in, but aside from all of this, what do you guys like to do, like, in your free time? Because I know you all have a life out of here, right? So what do you guys like to do when you're not in school?
You want to start, Eileen?
Well, for me personally, I like to go shopping.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. It's like, but it's not like just shopping. It's like the whole way of getting there. Like, you know, you get in a car and then you like drive to the mall or you drive to a store. And it's like the whole driving part. It's like very therapeutic. It's like very soothing when you get into like a vehicle and then you're just there. Like, you're listening to music.
Like, you're able to relax in that moment. Yeah. Like, you don't have to worry about school, about what needs to be
done. Like, it's just like getting to the destination.
And it's the adventure.
Mm-hmm. And then you could just listen to, like, random music that pops up. Or you can have, like, your own little playlist. Or, like, the most amazing conversations happen in a car ride somewhere.
Honestly, just going for a car ride, you know, just making my mom go to McDonald's or something. Yeah, I just want to sleep in the car. Like, do you guys agree that, like, sleeping in the car is, like, the best sleep?
Yes. Like, especially, like, after, like, if you went to, like, an XV, a baby shower, a wedding, a cookout.
Yes.
On the way back, you're, like, knocked out. And the best thing is, like, sometimes you don't even have to be the one driving.
Not for real.
It's when you start driving, that's when it's, like, ah, not anymore.
My favorite one is, like, whenever you go to the island and, like, that long drive.
Oh,
and then
yeah.
coming back, like, all tired and, like, it's just, like, the best car ride.
I could agree on that, since, like, with that. And also, I think if I'm ever stressed out or something, I literally like being outside. Like, if it means going to the beach, I love the beach. Mm-hmm. But if I can't go to the beach for whatever reason, I just, like, stay outside, be, like, more, like, in the sun sometimes. And since, like, where I live, there's, like, trees or whatever.
Uh-huh.
So I have, like, a little, like, chair near there. So I just sit down and I actually get to, like, I feel peace. Like, no one's bothering me. I'm with my dogs. And, like, that's all that matters for me sometimes.
Yes. Are there any hobbies that you guys, like, specifically do, like, every single day or, like, once in a while?
I think, honestly, my routine is just, like, with my dogs. Like, I get home, I feed them, I'm with them for a bit, and then I start doing my work. Or I'm actually reading a book. That's what I'll be doing.
Okay.
For me, it's reading. It's, like, I have entire bookshelves in my room that are just, like, oh, like, my dad had to build me a bookshelf into the wall.
Because,
like, I broke one with the weight of my books, and it was, like, I don't know. I just felt like that was an accomplishment, like, having so many books that
it
broke.
It is. Especially since it's something that, like, many people forget. They'll be like, oh, like, reading's not fun. And it's, like, when you actually start reading the book, it's, like, you're a character in the book as well. It's, like, you're seeing it from a third perspective. And I like it because it's, like, whatever you may be doing, let's say you're struggling in school and, like, you want an escape, but you can't really escape your home.
Yeah.
You read a book and it's, like, your mind's literally somewhere else, which is what I love a lot, especially when there's no picture books. Because you get to create your own characters and the way they see, they look, and you get to pick sides and however you want.
So are you guys like the people that think the book is better than the movie?
Yes.
I mean, it depends really on the movie adaptation, but most of the times the book is better.
Yeah, because with the book, you get to actually like hear their thoughts and see what they felt when all these things were going on. And the movie is like, you look at it and you're expecting it to be exactly like the book. And it's like nothing the same sometimes.
Well, that's very interesting, you know, never really, well, I'm not much of a reader. You know, like, I know that if I get a book and I start reading, I may get interested in it. But, like, yeah. Así nomás, I want to read a book. I'm not, like,
and it's, like, people start in books sometimes, right? Like,
yeah. I start them but never finish them. But anyway. So, last question or last thing that, you know, I want to ask you guys to end this podcast is, what advice would you give to, you know, any Lobo here at Lopez, you know, or just in general, what is a message you want to send out?
I think a message I'd like to send out to any Lobo out there, freshmen especially, is that make sure that when you do things, you're doing it because you want to do it. Don't do something because you feel like you're pressured into doing it. Because right now you might think like, oh, I'm young, nothing's going to affect me. But best believe that it is. Like, just because, like, you want to start a random fight with someone, like, no, be the bigger person, be the better person, and know that anything you do, the moment you walk into the school, the moment even when you walk back home, it's going to affect you. And remember, like, make sure you have control of your life, have that liberty and independence, and especially that determination. Be determined to succeed, because you know what? Sometimes we're known as, like, a low-poverty school, but don't let that be the story that you get to tell everyone and be like, but you know what? I still succeeded. Make sure that, let's say you have a planner, make sure you put everything to date, make sure you're on top of your things.
Yeah.
And try not to forget, like, it's okay to make mistakes, just remember that, as long as you learn from that mistake. Yeah. And I think my main message is be good and be determined always.
Yeah. What about you, Aileen?
So for me, it would be, like, it doesn't matter what you're going to do, right? Just try to be the best at it. Or, like, the best that you possibly can. Like, if you see that there's somebody better than you and you feel like I can be better than them, then try harder. Just,
like,
be better
motivated.
Than them. Yeah. Like, have that motivation to keep on going.
Not just that, but, like, sometimes people, when they see someone else being better than them, like, it's good to have that competition, but don't let that little competition make you minimize the way you look at yourself or you interpret things. If you feel like, oh, they're beating you, you know what? You got to step on your game and make sure you do better. If she read, like, 10 pages, you read 20 pages. Or, like, do little things, but don't ever let them beating you or someone being better than you in life, let it, like, take a huge toll on you. Because at the end of the day, everyone is different on their own pace.
Yeah.
You do everything at your own pace as long as you succeed in the end.
Yeah. I think it's all about progress. And I think, like, a lot of people have a misconception about progress, you know, that they think it's always about taking, like, those big steps. But in reality, it's just, like, progress is going to look different every single day. You know, yes. Maybe it's just, like, a small step, a small action that you took that day, you know, and then tomorrow it can be, like, a bigger action that you take, you know. But it's all about continue moving on, no matter how small it may look to you or to anyone else. Like, it is your it's your life, it's your lane, you know, that the one that you're running at.
A lot of the time people tend to, like, give up in the early stages, but it's because the early stages aren't gonna always be, like, you're not gonna go from step one all the way to step 50. Like, it takes time, and you only move 3 steps in one day. And it's slowly, and sometimes you might feel like you're going backwards instead of forwards. But just know that as you continue on the process, it does look different. And by the time you know it, it's going to be better.
Yeah. Well, thank you guys so much, you know, for this advice and for just being here today. You know, so do you guys want to say bye to our audience?
Yes. This is Jole Mercado, Ambassador's President, signing off.
This is Aileen Flores, Ambassador Historian, also signing off.
Thank you guys so much. So there you have it, folks, our first show of Lopez Life Tells of the Lobo. Stay tuned for more captivating stories from the amazing students right here at Lopez High School. Remember to subscribe and share our podcast to spread the inspiration. Until next time, this is Leslie Algaraz signing off.